flash time we have seen that the electric current is produced due to the free electrons present in a matter or material. So there is a free electrons which are flowing unidirectional, means they are flowing in a one direction, then the electric current is produced. But what is the reason behind the flow of electron in a one direction? Generally you know that the current is always produced due to some of the difference, like the air current, which is known as a wind, is flowed due to the pressure difference, high pressure to the lower pressure. Like that, a water is also flowed due to the altitude difference, a higher altitude to the lower altitude. So generally this type of current is produced due to some of the difference, a pressure difference. Like if we are thinking about a two tank which is filled with the water, right? Like that. So here is one tank which is connected with the other one. Right? There is one valve. Initially it is closed. Okay? And there is some water in this tank. So like that, and here also some of the water present in this tank. Open the valve. What happens? From this end to this end, water will flow. Till the pressure of water becomes same. As you know that there is a more water, means there is a more pressure of water in this end. At here, the lower pressure. So always, the flow of water is from higher pressure to the lower pressure till the pressure becomes same. As the height of water becomes same, the pressure will also become same. So after that, it stops flowing. Like that, for flow of electric current, there should be also the electric pressure difference, which is known as electric potential. So if there is an electric potential difference, then and only then the electric current will flow. And just because of that, you can show a plus and a minus on a battery, on a cell. Plus and minus is the electric potential difference. And just because of that, the electric current is flowing from positive to negative, which is the conventional reaction of electric current. Whenever the electric current is flowing from positive to negative, it is known as conventional electric current reaction. Because the electric current is flowing due to the electrons, right? And electrons are generally repelled by the negative and attract towards the positive. So electrons flow from negative to positive. Electrons are flowing from negative to positive. But before the discovery of electron, all the people just think that the electric current is flowing due to the positive charges. And just because of that, they were taking the flow of electric current from positive to negative. So it is known as conventional direction of electric current, which is from positive to negative. But when the J.J. Thomson discovered that electron, after that, everyone knows that the electric current is flowing due to the free electrons present in it, and which is flowing from negative to positive. But as you know that, always the conventionals are taken. So nowadays also, the electric current is shown from positive to negative. Understand? So electric current is flowing from positive to negative, but this is happened due to the electric potential difference. This is happened due to the electric potential difference. Just always remember that the conventional direction of electric current is from positive to negative, and the flow of electron is from negative to positive. Electrons are flowing from negative to positive, while the direction of electric current, the conventional direction of electric current, is from positive to negative. And we have to take the electric current direction from positive to negative. Always, we are not taking from negative to positive. A real direction we not consider here, right? We are always have to take the conventional direction. Now, back to the topic, the electric potential difference. So like that, if there is an electric pressure difference, then the electron can easily flow from one, one direction. Like if there is one positive and there is one negative, then electron will flow from positive to negative according to the conventional direction. According to the conventional direction, right? From positive to negative. So there should be an electric pressure difference. Then what is the electric potential difference? Right? Then what is the electric potential difference? For that, just think that there is one electric charge. It can be a positive or negative, right? An electric charge always attracts the opposite charge and always repels a like charge, right? So there is some region of it, a field of electric charge. As you know that if the force is applied by someone, then there should be some region, like a magnet. Magnet can attract an ion, but if the ion is far away from it, it cannot attract. There should be in a field. If the ion is in the field of magnet, like here it is a magnet, ion is at here, then it can easily attract by it. But after means outside of the field, it cannot attract. So there is some limit of the force of that magnet. Like that, all the charges have some limit, right? In which, if the light charge is outside of it, there is no repulsion, there is no attraction. But if it is inside of it, then if a light charge, then it repels, and if the unlight charge, then it attract by the central electric charge. Understand? So if you are thinking that here it is a one charge and a positive charge is at here on point A, right? As you know that if it is positive, then it repels. But if it is negative, then it attracts. Means if you want to maintain the position of this positive charge on A, you have to apply a force continuously, right? If it repels, then you have to just pull inside of it, right? Then you have to pull in inside of it. And if it is a negative, then it attracts towards it. For that, you have to push and maintain the position at A. So you have to always work to maintain that position, right? If you want to just move this positive charge from A to B, then for moving it, you have to do a work. You have to do a work. And this work is known as potential difference. As you know that the potential difference is a one type of energy, and it is also known as a work. So if you want to move that positive charge from point A to point B, then you have to do some work, and this work is known as the potential difference. So we can say that a work required to move unit positive charge from one point to the another point in electric field is known as electric potential difference. So the electric potential difference is the work required to move a unique positive charge from one point to the another point in electric field, which is known as electric potential difference. So this electric potential difference is also known as voltage, right? This is also known as voltage. So this voltage, which is denoted by V, is equal to a total work required. So there is a work for a unit charge. So there is a charge. So our equation is V is equal to W by Q, a work required by the electric charge. So the SI unit of voltage, SI unit of electric potential difference is, what is the SI unit? The SI unit of work is joule and the SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. So it is joule per coulomb, which is also known as volt because of Alexandra Volta, a scientist. Alexandra Volta, right? And just because of him, we are taking a joule per coulomb as a volt, which is also denoted by V. So the unit of V is also a V, right? So whenever you are calculating an electric potential difference, you have to put the unit as a volt. Understand? So here it is the electric potential difference, a work required to move a unit charge from one position to the another position. It is known as the potential difference, electric potential difference. So total work required to move a unit electric charge from one point to the another point in this electric field, which is known as electric potential difference. So according to it, our equation is V is equal to W by Q. And if you want to take the unit of V, then you have to take a unit of work and the charge, which is joule per coulomb, which is also known as watt. Okay. So as we have defined a unit in the last lecture, we have to also define the unit of this voltage, or the unit of this electric potential difference. Then what is the definition of it? The same way you have to define it as we have seen in the electric current, right? If a 1 coulomb electric charge element, as we have defined electric potential difference, we are going in the same way. So the work required, so the work required to move 1 coulomb electric charge from one point to another point in electric field is 1 joule. If the work required to move a 1 coulomb electric charge from one point to the another point in electric field is 1 joule, then it is known as as you know that for definition of a volt, as you know that volt is equal to joule per coulomb, like that joule per coulomb is equal to volt. So if you take a 1 joule and the 1 coulomb, then you get a 1 volt. So the work required is 1 joule for moving a 1 coulomb electric charge. So we are just putting the value of electric charge and the value of work in the definition of electric potential difference, and you get the definition of 1 volt, which is the work required to move 1 coulomb electric charge from one point to the another point in electric field is 1 joule, then it is known as 1 volt electric potential difference. So here it is the topic of electric potential difference. As you know that light, electric current is measured by a meter, the same way the electric potential difference is measured by voltmeter. Not a voltameter, it's a voltmeter, right? The electric potential difference is measured by voltmeter. You have to remember and give attention on every word that the electric potential difference is measured by voltmeter. Voltmeter is not used for measuring the electric potential. The voltmeter is not used for measuring electric potential, but this measures the electric potential difference. Understand? It always measures the difference. Electric potential difference. So here it is our topic of electric potential. Now there is some sums related to these equations which can be asked in your exam for 2 marks. What are the questions? First of all, we are going to see question number 12.2. Right? How much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across 2 points having a potential difference 12 volt? Okay, now there is a charge is given to you, right? In exercise 12.2, a charge means a Q is given to you, which is 2 coulomb, right? Then there is a potential difference is given to you, which is V. V is equal to 12 volt. What do you have to find? How much work is done, right? So you have to find out W. So you have the equation V is equal to W by Q, right? Now V is a 12, W by Q is a 2. So the 2L into 2 is equal to W. So the W is equal to 12, 2 is a 24 joule. So W is equal to 24 joule. It's an easy one, right? That you know the Q and the V, then you can easily find out the W. Now, the another question, question number 6. How much work is done for moving a 2 coulomb of electric charge from 6 volt to the 12 volt, right? This question is just given by me, right? There is no question like this in a book. So whenever I am sending a PDF, you have to write this question from a PDF only, right? So how much work is done for moving a 2 coulomb of electric charge from 6 volt to the 12 volt? Now there is one question extra. So there is a electric charge is given to you, which is 2 coulomb, right? And electric charge from 6 volt to the 12 volt. So there is a 2 potential difference are given to you. So we are taking this, V1 is equal to 6 volt and the V2 is equal to 12 volt. And you have to find out the W. As you know that, this equation is for the electric potential difference. V is the electric potential difference. So here it is the electric potential difference V is equal to V2 minus V1. So 12 minus 6 gives us 6 volt. Now V is equal to W by Q. Understand? Here it is the electric potential difference. Electric potential difference. We want a difference. Right? In an equation there is a difference. In the first question, the question is how much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across the 2 point having a potential difference 12 volt. And the another question, how much work is done for moving a 2 coulomb of electric charge from 6 volt to 12 volt? There is no potential difference is given to you. They are just saying that here it is a 6 volt, here it is a 12 volt. What is the work to move the electric charge from 6 to 12? Right? And in the first question, they give this electric potential difference directly, right? So whenever they are giving an electric potential difference directly, you can use it. But if there is no electric potential difference and there is a two voltages, then you have to subtract, right? Then you get a difference of electric potential. Now, V is a 6, W is equal to, that we have to find, and here it is the 2. So W is equal to 6 into 2, which you get W is equal to 12 joule. So like that you can find out the value. Right? Now there are some other questions I given to you. Index question, right? What is the question? Name a device that helps to maintain a potential difference across a conductor. As you know that if there is a conductor, and if you want a potential difference, what you can use? Then you can use a cells or a battery. As you know that if there is a battery, then one side becomes positive and another side becomes negative. So it produces an electric potential difference. And we are using also a pencil cells in which that you can see a positive and a negative, which also shows the potential difference. So if you want to maintain the potential, if the wires are just like that, there is no electric flow because there is no electric potential difference. But whenever you connect with a battery, the electric potential difference produces. So for maintaining this difference, we are using a batteries or a cells, right? Now, how much energy is given to each conductor of a charge passing through a 6-volt battery? Now, what we have to find, it's also an equation, the third question it is that how much energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through a 6-volt battery? The energy is also one type of what? So each coulomb means that Q is a 1 coulomb and V is a 6-volt. Then you have to find W again. So V is equal to W by Q. V is equal to 6, W, Q is equal to 1. So 6 into 1 is equal to W. So the W is equal to 6 joule. Work done and the energy, both are same. So, for each coulomb across the 6-volt, that battery gives a 6 joule of energy to move it. So here is some of the questions related to the electric potential difference. Like that, there is some of other questions related to the electricity, right? That one of them is done by us in a last lecture, right? Another one is from exercise 12.1. That you have to do by your own self. Exercise 12.1, right? In which that you have to find out the Q, right? Current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament of electric bulb for 10 minutes. Find the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. Then there is a I is given to you, T is given to you, and you can easily find out the Q, right? Same as the question, exercise. It is from the that I have done in the last lecture, example number 12.1. The same manner, right? So you have to do by your own self, okay? There is another question like that. So here is our topic. I am just finishing it here, right? The another topic we will see in a next lecture.